So, is it ever okay to cheer an injury? That's what we will be diving into here today. Welcome to That's Good Sports. I am Brandon. For the first time in human history, Canadians are known as bad boys to the rest of the world, Perna. The Warriors won Game 5 of the NBA Finals, despite only getting 12 minutes out of their back-to-back Finals MVP Kevin Durant. Unfortunately, that's because just after scoring 11 points in those short 12 minutes, his Achilles snapped like a rubber band. Now, if I know anything about Canada, the Raptors fans all engaged in an immediate moment of Canadian silence, shed some Canadian tears, and offered up their Canadian healthcare.
It's the right calf that put him out.
Oh no. Just kidding, they seem to be assholes, just like the rest of us. I wanted to talk about this game and the KD injury because I find it fascinating how the sports world has reacted, how fans have reacted, and think it's a great example of no matter what you do, you can never win in sports, which is weird considering it's typically the one place where the scoreboard clearly defines winners and losers. I'll explain what I mean, recap the game a bit, and discuss injury etiquette for fans. That's good sports. Please, noobs, subscribe here. Click the notification button. Also, I have big dick Patreon shoutouts for my patrons, Tom Brady. I'm assuming that's not the real Tom Brady, Bob R, and Keith Clark. You can support this channel at patreon.com/thatsgoodsports with a monthly donation. You don't have to, but I appreciate it. Now, because of basic human decency, I should not have to explain why cheering an injury is bad. But here we are. Just imagine getting hurt. Getting hurt really bad, and then having thousands of people express joy for your pain. That's basically what happened to Kevin Durant. Now, in defense of Canada, cheering KD, I need to say two things. First, they're used to being hockey fans, a sport that embraces injury. It's fair to say they don't have a clue how to participate in basketball games as a fan base. Second, healthcare there is free. The primary reason we as Americans sympathize with injuries so much, besides pain, is we know how fucking expensive it is. Oh, you tore your Achilles? You better start a GoFundMe campaign. Get injured in a car wreck? Get ready to fight with your auto and health insurance. Want to sell one of your kidneys on the dark web to pay for your Achilles surgery? Well, you better know how to remove and store organs yourself. That's our medical system in a nutshell. Now maybe it's comforting to know that our neighbors to the north have more in common with us Americans than we thought. Or maybe it's that deep down, the adrenaline from seeing your team 48 minutes from their first ever title turns everyone, even some docile Canadians, into rabid assholes that react poorly in the heat of the moment. I mean, I've heard Broncos fans yell, "Mike Shanahan is a dumb fuck who couldn't coach my butt." A quote you don't easily forget, and that was after he won his Super Bowls. I've heard vile racist things screamed at football games. And most shockingly, I heard someone say Brady Quinn is ugly. I'm sure after the totality of Durant's injury set in, everyone that was cheering, even this douchebag in the front row who was waving goodbye while KD was checking to make sure his tendon was still attached to the bone, felt shitty after the fact. And it seems like they did, because when Durant hobbled off the court, they gave him a standing ovation, probably because his burner accounts already started roasting them on Twitter. That's how good KD is. And here's the thing about the Warriors. They came right back from the dead to win in the most gutsy fashion possible. They're essentially the NBA's version of the Mountain. You can't fuck around, because unless you know without a doubt they're dead, they could still sweep you off your feet, gouge your eyes out, and pop your head like a grapefruit at a moment's notice. and for the Toronto Martels, they're two games away from that being their fate. Luckily for them, I still think they have the upper hand because they have the best player in the entire postseason in Kawhi Leonard, who very nearly won the game by himself last night after scoring 10 points over a 90-second stretch in the fourth quarter. It was only until Gary Oldman / Drew Carey lookalike Nick Nurse called timeout during that amazing run and killed Toronto's momentum did Golden State claw back into it with three threes between Klay Thompson and Steph Curry. And then, on the final possession, with the Raptors down one with the chance to win the entire series, they had the brilliant idea to not let Kawhi get a shot off, instead let Kyle Lowry take a corner three, which quite literally did not even hit the broad side of the backboard. It was mind-boggling. We only need 2 points, but let's take three. That's the very definition of greed, kids. You know who else took three when they only needed two? The Mummy, Terminator, Shrek, Ghostbusters, and most importantly, Home Alone. Home Alone is where all Raptors fans who cheered KD's injury should be watching Game 6, by the way. The series does go back to Oakland, meaning Game 6 on Thursday will officially be the last game in Oracle. It's going to be an incredibly tough environment for the Raptors to get a win, but I know that some things will even out from Game 5. First, I think Kawhi will shoot better than 37% from the field. As good as he was in the fourth quarter, this might have been his worst game in the postseason, all things considered, because he shot 9 for 24 and 2 for 7 from 3, even though he did add 12 boards and 6 assists. Second, I don't think Golden State will shoot 22% better than Toronto from three again. Pascal Siakam, Danny Green, and Kyle Lowry combined to go 1 for 14 from 3 on Monday, while Steph Curry, Klay Thompson, and Draymond Green, and KD, while he was playing, shot 17 of 34 from downtown. If you put me in an NBA game, I could easily go 1 for 14 from the three-point line. I could also dunk if I'm like Jim Carrey from Cable Guy jumping off of somebody's back. Finally, as tough as they played down the stretch, Golden State is going to be shorthanded in Game 6 and 7 if it gets that far. We know KD is out, but Kevin Looney also re-aggravated his injury after playing 17 minutes last night and probably won't play again, meaning the Warriors will have to get contributions from guys who have done nothing all series long. Basically, they need to find their brand Stark. So even though Toronto should have closed it out last night, I think they'll still find a way to win this series. But will Canada ever find a way to win back our respect? To answer the question this video poses, is it ever okay to cheer an injury in sports? The simple answer is no, especially because you never know the extent of an injury. Durant didn't look bad. Turns out, he may never be the same again. So if you cheer for that, you have to accept the fact that you're an asshole. What I find incredibly ironic, especially in sports, is that even some of the worst people draw the line in injury. They will shit on athletes relentlessly and more mean-spiritedly for any other reason, but suddenly have morality if a guy gets hurt. Why? Because we all understand physical pain, and we know in our hearts Patrick Swayze is a fucking liar.
Do you enjoy pain?
Pain don't hurt.
Ah, pain does hurt, Patrick. It hurts bad. Kevin Durant is one of the most heavily criticized players in the NBA, and the same people who have said far worse to him on Twitter are now signing up for the military to attack Canada in his honor. I think sports fans were honestly just caught off guard because of the overwhelming use of the stereotype that Canadians are all kind people. Probably the same reaction well-hung Asian men get. Here's the thing though, we as sports fans, we decent ones, don't ever root for a player injury outwardly. But if you don't believe most sports fans would be totally okay with a significant injury to the opposing team if it meant their team would get a big win, you are lying to yourself. Fans don't really give a shit about player injuries unless it's horrific. All fans really care about is watching their team win and getting drunk, and not necessarily in that order. I would never cheer for an injury, but I also do not expect nice things from sports fans. That's what I really found fascinating about the outrage surrounding this situation. Here's how crazy sports fans are. Michael Rapaport tweeted, "Classless to cheer for any player to ever get hurt." To which I quote tweeted, "What if you were a psychic and you cheered for OJ to get hurt?" Now maybe I should have said time traveler instead of psychic, but one or two people still defended OJ. Fucking OJ, saying cheering for an OJ Simpson injury would be classless. That's the level of insanity we deal with in the world of sports. So to answer the question again, to be very clear, because I don't want people mistaking this, it's not okay to cheer for injuries, unless you're a time traveler and you know that that athlete is truly a shitty person. Side note, the more money a player has already made can affect the level of sympathy fans feel for them during an injury. On the flip side, if you as a fan are super rich, there's no way to tell how you'll react if a key player gets hurt. My recommendation, regardless of money, is that the appropriate reaction when you see the injury, acceptable reactions are, I hope he's okay. When they are getting up off the field or court, it's the aggressive golf clap. With a head nod, showing you want to see that they're okay, even though the fact that they're getting off the court or field does not mean they are okay in any way at all. But you do this, and you wait for a thumbs up on a football field. And afterwards, you don't go on Twitter and say something like you're glad that that player got hurt. That's all you have to do. Basically, you want to react somewhere in between Drake and ass butt bye-bye waiver. The reason I think everything that surrounds the world of sports is constant insanity is because there's always a counterpoint to every situation. The Warriors won the game, but at what cost? They lost Kevin Durant. The Warriors should be blamed for Kevin Durant's injury, allowing him to play on a bad leg. Kevin Durant should be blamed. He should have known not to play on that bad leg. But if KD didn't play, people would have called him soft. He clearly didn't care about winning and only cared about money, only cared about his long-term health and future in the NBA. Championships happen now. Why would KD jeopardize all of next season for at best a couple games and another ring? But only the true greats risk everything when it matters the most in the championships. The point is, if you want to make it in sports media, you better be willing to take the side of something you don't believe in at all, because you need to argue about it. Thanks for watching another episode of That's Good Sports. Please subscribe here on YouTube. I'm on Twitter, Instagram, at Brandon Perna. Mostly do football, but found this pretty interesting. Give @WillKey6 a follow, especially if you want more basketball-related Twitter tweets. Will knows a lot about basketball. He helps me with basketball a lot, just so you know.